This right here, that's a goldfish. And why am I telling you that? Mostly because I just want to get your attention. That's what we call a pattern interrupt in copywriting and marketing. It's essentially presenting something to the reader or the viewer that they wouldn't expect, and that gets their attention. And then you can guide them along the sales copy, the video, whatever it might be. And in this video, I'll actually teach you how to use pattern interrupts in your copywriting and marketing to drive more engagement and conversions. Now, pattern interrupts come from the practice of neurolinguistic programming, or NLP, which is essentially the approach of changing someone's thoughts and behaviors to guide them in a certain direction and achieve a certain outcome. Now, in this case, as a marketer or a copywriter, you would use pattern interrupts and NLP in general to guide people along the sales copy, the video, the funnel, and eventually convert into a customer, maybe fill out a form, opt into something, and overall, you have that goal in mind and you help them achieve that. You see, even if you have an open mind, we all have preconceived notions and ideas of how certain things work, and that's just based on our own experiences and understanding of the world. So, for example, if someone cold called you, you might have the expectation that they're going to introduce themselves, say who they are, their company, and then try to sell you. But if you picked up the phone and someone started talking about your favorite football team and your hobbies, that would probably really take you back, and once again, it would break that pattern. And you'd be more interested in actually staying on the phone because it's so different and it interrupts your thinking in that process. So where are you gonna use pattern interrupts? Now, ideally it's gonna be at the very beginning of an interaction. Now, if you're doing copywriting, this is probably gonna be in the headline where you're gonna make a bold statement, you're gonna say something that's very curiosity inducing, or you're gonna use some very interesting data and stats to break people's attention or what they would expect. So try to go a bit against the grain and think about what your buyer persona is interested in, what they're thinking, what they're feeling, and then say something opposite to that to get their attention. So take the Motley Fool, for example. Now, while you would normally get modest recommendations like how to make an extra $400 a month passive investing, they actually use pattern interrupting here for one of their newsletter signups by making a huge statement saying that the next billion-dollar Apple secret is here. And for this specific audience, it would be a bit outside the norm, once again breaking that pattern of what they would expect from the Motley Fool, and then being interested in actually opting in this case. This principle is also amazing for emailing, because most people open emails based on the subject line alone. So if your subject line isn't very good when you're doing cold outreach, cold emailing, and so on, you're not gonna get very good results. So instead of using a really predictable subject line like quick question or hey John, you can actually say something very different, and then they're gonna open that and be much more likely to engage with you, and you're also much more memorable in the inbox. Once again, try using a bold statement, say something against the grain in that specific industry or business, or you can actually do research on that specific prospect and bring up some kind of custom observation or compliment that they wouldn't expect someone else to say. Then do the exact same thing inside the email, so continue off that strategy by elaborating on that compliment, the observation, use more data, make a bold claim, and keep that going, and then transition it into your offer. Thirdly, pattern interrupts are amazing and probably actually used the most when it comes to sales calls and cold calling, because normally the scripts are very similar in how people interrupt and how people interpret and experience cold calls tends to be very similar, and it can be very hard to actually stand out. So if you use pattern interrupts, it's gonna hook someone's attention and they're gonna be much more likely to actually hear your sales pitch and convert. It's been proven in one study that actually starting off a phone call just by asking, hey, how have you been, can greatly increase success. And when you think about why this is, it's actually pretty simple, because instead of expecting someone to immediately pitch themselves and their product, it almost sounds like an old friend catching up and touching base with you. So that instantly gets you more interested, and it breaks that pattern, makes them more comfortable, and then they'll actually listen to the sales call. But let's actually go over some examples of pattern interrupts so you can actually see how it manifests and what it looks like, beginning with a famous ad for Hathaway shirts by none other than David Ogilvy. And now in this ad for one of these shirts, remember this is a shirt ad, it starts off with some pretty interesting headlines and copy, because the headline starts off with how three trunks of India Madras started Yale University, which is a bit of a curiosity-inducing headline. And then immediately the sales copy jumps into some character and his experience traveling to India for this rare material. Also note how they use the man with the eye patch wearing this shirt, and it gets you wondering who this gentleman is. Now remember, this is an ad for a shirt. It's definitely not what you would expect for this kind of product, but once again, it breaks that pattern, gets you interested, and then it talks more about the features, the benefits, the pricing, and actually how to order one. So when you are doing pattern interrupting like this, and it's that bold, you have to make sure that you smoothly transition into the product, or you can actually lose people. So here's another cool example. This is a banner ad from Awesome Web, the web design and development company. And normally when you have a banner ad, or any ad for that matter, online, obviously you want people to click it and get to the website, the landing page, wherever it might be, but not in the case of Awesome Web. They actually say, don't click here, to get your attention in the opposite way. Then of course it follows it up saying, unless you want awesome web designers and developers. So if you're gonna take this approach by saying, don't read this, don't click here, make sure you immediately follow up with some kind of reason. The digital library scribe.com also does a very literal and figurative pattern interrupt. So when you're on their mobile website and you're reading a document or a book, eventually you get a pop-up that tells you that if you want to continue reading that document, you need to download the mobile app. So this gets you using their product and service more, even if it's the free version, and then you're essentially in their funnel. They can remarket to you, upsell on other products and services. So you can also do this with software and apps. If you want to learn more about this copywriting strategy, go into the description and read my blog post on pattern interrupting. Make sure to also get my free courses and other material in there on copywriting. And other than that, subscribe if you're new to the channel, and I'll catch you in the next video.